Of late, he's been keeping something of a low profile, but the face of euthanasia in this country, Dr. Philip Nitschke, is persistent. He's back in the news, applying to federal health authorities to get his hands on the powerful sedative Nembutal, the drug of choice in some European countries for patients wanting to end their own lives, and one that's also used in the US for executions. I spoke with him earlier. Is that drug being brought in as a powerful sedative, as it is, we know that, is it brought in to assist these people to euthanise, that simply?
Assisting a suicide's a crime, so it would be illegal to do that, and that's made quite clear under the special access provisions of the Therapeutic Goods Administration. So it's being brought in as a powerful sedative to make sure they get a good night's sleep, but they will derive comfort from knowing they've got a drug which, if they misused, would give them a peaceful death.
I'd like to talk about that word misuse in a moment, but how long have these people got to live? Are they people who are dying?
Yes, they're Category A people, which means that that's defined in the Act. It means they've got months, the life expectancy in the order of months. And there's six of them, although they've also been contacted by a new person in Tasmania today who's asked to be involved as well.
Right, so you've suggested that they take these pills, this Nembutal, which in fact, by the way, as I hear it, is used as a euthanasia pill in some parts of the world and used in executions in the US. So it's pretty powerful. It's about as powerful as it can get.
Yes, look, it's a drug that's been around for a long time as a sleeping tablet, but it fell into disuse as a sleeping tablet in the late 50s, although it's a drug that's used around the world now, as you say, where places and in countries where you can have access to legal help to die, and it is increasingly being used by the Americans for in the execution context.
So it can cause death?
Oh, yeah. I mean, it's well known, but it's also a very effective sedative which plays a role in the case of terminally ill people that are having great difficulty, getting restful sleep.
Yeah, but, I mean, you can see what I'm getting at. I mean, you said if they misuse it, and I think you're quoted as saying if that's their business, if they do, what would misusing it be, and what's the difference between misusing and overdosing, consciously or otherwise?
Well, I mean, these are rational people. They're dying, they're rational. They know what they're doing, and it's been very clearly explained to them what this drug is. Now, many people go overseas and try illegally to acquire this drug. They don't want to do that, but they do think they should have access to it, and they do have very good reasons for acquiring it for legitimate medical purposes. And I'm, as their treating doctor, in each of the six or now seven with the Tasmanian cases, applying on their behalf for that use.
Yeah, have any of these people said to you that they do intend using it to suicide?
No, what they've said is that they would really feel a whole lot better if they knew they had access to the drug.
And so you're really thinking the federal authorities will give you the access that you want? Do you think you'll get this right to import them?
Well, no, I gather Nicola Roxon, our health minister, just made some reference to the fact that I'd be deregistered if I went down that path. Now, of course, that, of course, begs the question. I mean, I'm not prescribing the drug so they can die, so I'm not about to prescribe this drug or make it available if we get permission through the Therapeutic Goods Administration for them to take this path. So that'll have to be established before I get deregistered.
But you acknowledge the fact that not used properly, even if they don't intend to it, they could kill themselves.
They could, and I should also point out here that that's not a crime. Suicide is not a crime in Australia.
But assisting them is.
Yes, definitely.
So you could be in strife.
Well, if that's why I'm assisting them, but assisting a doctor's assisting people getting a good night's sleep is not a crime at all. In fact, it's considered to be good medical practice. Now, I guess you can see where I'm coming from, and certainly we're trying to exploit what seems to be an avenue.
Well, as usual, Philip, you couldn't be accused of not telling us where you're coming from, but you've certainly got our attention yet again. But thanks for talking so frankly to us.
Thanks, George.